some well-wishers and fans. We know that Vice President Pence will not be there. He said he could not do the inauguration as well as this farewell event. So it'll be interesting to see who is there when President Trump arrives. Again, he's president until noon today. It is not as if this moment marks the end of anything. It is after the inauguration at noontime that President Trump will no longer be president of the United States.
Yeah, and as you mentioned, this is a scene we have seen many times before, but not at this moment, not in the morning. And here's some of the tape playback of the president giving that final wave just into our newsroom. So we're showing that final wave from a different vantage point, but he is now, the picture on your left is a live picture where Marine One is about to depart. But normally this all would take place after the inauguration, after a shaking of hands, after to leave town early, head to this celebration. Just a different feel in the closing days of this administration.
Yeah, Savannah, that's exactly right. I was anticipating that peaceful transfer of power at the Capitol, the inauguration process. Instead, the peaceful transfer of power this day, of course, is being guaranteed, secured by 25,000. That's incitement of many of his supporters to head there. As you watch Marine One pick up.
As we watch this, I'm struck because we have this wide vantage point of the White House and the whole complex. And if you look to the top left of your screen, and you, if you were to see the street right across is Blair House. Mm. And Blair House is where the president-elect Joe Biden spent the evening and is right now. And that is as close as the out to take the oath of office afternoon today.
Yes, and
clarity early today, we heard from members of Joe Biden's team that there has been no direct contact.
How long is this ride, Savannah?
It's just a few minutes, 5-10 minutes.
Yeah.
It's the Joint Base Andrews is just a few minutes outside of Washington, and that's the quickest way to get there.
Yeah.
Marine One, and it also affords that over a city in lockdown, whose mall is closed. Spectators, other than a handful, not allowed.
Because to travel quickly, so it certainly seems to be about more than logistics. That.
So the president said his goodbye, but he hopes to come and bid farewell to the president. Here he is arriving.
Yeah, I think Kristen Welker is with us just for a second. Kristen, what did you make of those remarks? You said it was a goodbye, but not a long-term goodbye.
Well, and I anticipate we will hear him echo that when he does make remarks towards everything that is at stake. Savannah and Hoda.
And we're positioned and ready for the flight back to Florida, and the president expected to address the crowd, which includes
not take into account sort of the solemnity of the day. These are the raucous rock and roll tunes that have been a part of rally life for Donald Trump. I think we'll have more patriotic music when the military band plays, but as you can see, his adult children are here, some friends are here. Notably, it is not the kind of...
That's who's got the front row seat, and now we just saw the stairs open. And we will await the president's final emergence from Marine One as president of the United States.
Typically, the agents exit first and then the president, so it might be another moment or two here. But Marine One is one of the most unique experiences a president can enjoy. There are some of the agents before the president deplanes. And like the former president,
new campaign. Do you expect to hear words like that from the president today?
An allusion to that, Savannah, certainly, and it's not insignificant as we watch the president now depart Marine One for the last time as president of the United States with First Lady Melania Trump behind him. It is not insignificant that he has now alluded to the idea that it's not a long-term goodbye to the White House. The campaign rally music is no surprise. It is no secret. It is a signal that this is still a president who is intent on campaigning. He will continue, by all accounts, to hold rallies. He will continue to work his base, if you will, and look at what his political future holds. There are those around the president, Savannah, who question whether he will actually run or whether he will perhaps just talk about running. But let's listen in here in case the president does make some remarks before stepping up to the mics.
Well, and the other big question, for us, Hallie, is what happens in this impeachment trial? If he were to be convicted, would there be then a next vote requiring only a majority of the Senate to ban him from holding office in the future? There's the 21-gun salute. Let's listen.
Thank you very much, and we love you, and I can tell you that from the bottom of my heart. This has been an incredible 4 years. We've accomplished so much together. I want to thank all of my family and my friends and my staff and so many other people for being here. I want to thank you for your effort, your hard work. People have no idea how hard this family worked. They worked, and they worked for you. They could have had a much easier life, but they did a fantastic job. I just want to thank all of you, everyone. I want to thank Mark Meadows, who's here someplace right there. I want to thank Mark. But it's been something very special. We've accomplished a lot. Our First Lady has been a woman of great grace and beauty and dignity. And so popular with the people, so popular with the people. In fact, honey, would you like to say a few words, please?
Being your First Lady was my greatest honor. Thank you for your love and your support. You will be in my thoughts and prayers. God bless you all. God bless your families. And God bless this beautiful nation.
What else has to be said, right? But what we've done, that's true, honey, great job. What we've done has been amazing by any standard. We rebuilt the United States military. We created a new force called Space Force. That in itself would be a major achievement for a regular administration. We were not a regular administration. We took care of the vets, 91% approval rating. They've never had that before. The vets have given us, the VA, the vets have given us an approval rating like has never been before. We took care of our vets and our beautiful vets. They were very badly treated before we came along. And as you know, we get them great service and we pick up the bill and they can go out and they can see a doctor if they have to wait long periods of time. We got it so that we can, sadly, get rid of people that don't treat our vets properly. We didn't have any of those rights before when I came on, so our vets are happy, our people are happy, our military is thrilled. We also got tax cuts, the largest tax cut and reform in the history of our country by far. I hope they don't raise your taxes, but if they do, I told you so. And if you look at the regulations, which I consider the regulation cuts to be maybe even more important, that's why we have such good and have had such good job numbers. The job numbers have been absolutely incredible. When we started, had we not been hit by the pandemic, we would have had numbers that would never have been seen. Already our numbers are the best ever. If you look at what happened until February a year ago, our numbers were at a level that nobody had ever seen before. Amazing people. This is a great, great country. It is my greatest honor and privilege to have been your president. will always fight for you. I will be watching, I will be listening, and I will tell you that the future of this country has never been better. I wish the new administration great luck and great success. I think they'll have great success. They have the foundation to do something really spectacular. And again, we put it in a position like it's never been before, despite the worst plague to hit since, I guess you'd say, 1917, over 100 years ago. And despite that, the things that we've done have been just incredible, and I couldn't have done it without you. So just a goodbye. We love you. We will be back in some form. And again, I want to thank our Vice President, Mike Pence, and Karen. I want to thank Congress, because we really worked well with Congress, at least certain elements of Congress. But we really did. We've gotten so much done that nobody thought would be possible. But I do want to thank Congress. And I want to thank all of the great people of Washington, D.C., all of the people that we worked with to put this miracle together. So, have a good life. We will see you soon. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
President Trump and his final remarks to the nation, to some supporters who were gathered at Joint Base Andrews, throwing out the script just like he came in. He's leaving in the exact same way.
You know, though, for him, that was, I don't know what I would call it, subdued, I guess is probably not quite the right word, and I wouldn't use melancholy, but there was sort of an odd acceptance to the moment that we heard from him in a way that we hadn't. For the last 2 months, but I'm just sorry. I'm YMCA? I mean, really? I'm sorry. I'm just sort of struck by the, as Kelly, I thought, really put it well. The music doesn't match the solemnity of the moment. It's probably the understatement that has been said in our air. But I will say this. I think the most fascinating theme of his remarks was he essentially wants to say, I have a feeling the economy is going to get better. I have a feeling vaccines are coming, and I want the credit. And so we probably did get a preview of when we hear from the soon-to-be former president in the next 6 months, if there are good things that are happening under President Biden's watch, he is going to want to take a lot of credit. And obviously anything bad, I'm sure he will try to say that he had nothing to do with that. But in that sense, it was almost sort of a normal way for a president to lead, trying to say, hey, I've handed you something that you should be able to build on. So I go through this entire morning and wonder, imagine if President Trump acted with some humility for the last 2 months, what all of these moments might have looked like today.
Yeah, you talk about the music, Chuck, and that's something that we've been talking about, but it is true. He did say he'd be back, and you did mention that these are songs that he plays at his campaign rally, yeah. So, you know, this may be just his way of getting started again.
He also said he'd be watching and listening.
Yes.
That we can be sure of. But Hallie, he'll be watching and listening without his megaphone that propelled him to office, at least in his own estimation. Twitter, Facebook, mm-hmm. Instagram, social media. So a lot of people have wondered whether the president would get into the media business, whether he has plans to have his message heard in some new form.
And that's been some of the speculation. Does a president who has used the force of specifically conservative media to amplify his message create his own kind of platform? That's also, Savannah, really expensive. That's a big financial ask. And so there are some questions, I think, from folks that I've talked to in our reporting on whether that could actually happen. But it is something in the air as President Trump claps along to the sounds of the YMCA there and gets ready to make his last wave before boarding what is still Air Force One now for the last time as president. He'll step off, of course, in Palm Beach down at his Mar-a-Lago estate. You referenced, both you and Hoda, how the president previewed he's going to be back or he hopes to be back. But I'm struck when we look at that shot of the president's family members. There are multiple people there with the White House of Donald Trump Jr., the president's son, who has been a surrogate over the last couple of years for his father.
I saw a few moments ago emerging from Blair House. Vice President Biden, President-elect Biden, Vice President-elect Kamala Harris departing to begin their.
Just a matter of hours today, I'm struck by this moment, the incoming First Lady, the incoming President Joe Biden waiting respectfully for President Trump to finish his remarks before physically entering the screen. And we have a dramatic split screen here outside the White House where a moment, you know, just moments ago we saw Marine One rise above the residence, and just literally a football field away from there, you could see the Bidens then a short time ago departing as well. You talk about those themes of unity, and he's trying to reinforce those themes, President-elect Joe Biden. It's going to be about the American people, and those close to Joe Biden tell me that he, in effect, is the perfect president for this moment, a man who, through the course of his life, has experienced so many personal traumas, the loss of...
Yes, a White House official says that the president did leave a note for...
He'll have signed his name, but this will be the last time he signs it without president before it.
Wow. Wow. That's interesting. And Peter Alexander, as they fly to Mar-a-Lago on Air Force One, Donald Trump is still technically president for the next
massive megaphone, not having the bullhorn of Twitter. So, of course, yesterday for me personally in the West Wing, saying goodbye to many of the White House aides, they lose their White House email. They lose the White House cell phones they shared. And so the question is sort of what he forms post-presidency, President Trump does, from Mar-a-Lago as he maintains his position on the political stage, obviously with President Trump aboard it for the last time.
We will watch as Air Force One takes off, and we now have a picture inside the church. And so one president leaves, another prepares to take the solemn oath of office. And we will continue to watch this. And this is a day now which will look more like inaugurations past, where you see the president-elect and the vice president-elect attend church than the swearing in, an inaugural speech, as a modified parade, Hoda, because...